Welcome. In this video, we discuss and solve problems involving cash discounts. Cash discounts are offered by businesses to encourage prompt or early payments of bills or invoices. The seller will provide a time period on the invoice within which discounts are allowed. If the buyer pays within that period, the buyer gets the discount. So what's the difference between cash discounts and trade discounts? Trade discount is given on the list price, while cash discount is given on the net price. Trade discount is applied because the buyer makes a purchase, irrespective of when they pay, while cash discount is applied because the buyer pays early within a specified period. Therefore, a cash discount is an incentive given to the buyer to pay early. There are various presentations of cash discount terms and dating methods, but we'll focus mainly on ordinary dating here. Here's a common example. This is read 210 net 30. The 210 means that the buyer gets a 2% discount if they pay within 10 days. The net 30 means that the net price is due in 30 days. After 30 days, the buyer might be assessed a late fee or an interest charge based on agreed terms between the buyer and the seller. Here's another example. 510, 315, net 30. This means that 5% discount applies for payments made within the first 10 days, and 3% discount applies to payment made after 10 days but within 15 days. And whatever amount remains unpaid after 15 days must be paid within 30 days. After 30 days, a fee or a penalty may apply. Another dating approach is called end-of-month dating, or EOM. This approach makes the payment terms effective on the last day of the month. That is, you start counting from day 1 of the following month. In this case, 210 net 30 EOM means that the 2% discount will apply till the 10th day of the next month. So whether the invoice was issued on March 2nd or March 22nd, the last date to take advantage of the 2% discount is April 10th, and the last day to fully pay the net price without penalty is April 30th. Another dating approach is receipt of goods, or ROG approach. This approach makes the payment terms effective on the date the goods are received. That is, you start counting from the day after the goods are received. If nothing is appended to the payment terms like EOM and ROG, then the terms apply from the invoice date. And like we saw before, we refer to that as ordinary dating. Let's now solve some ordinary dating problems. A merchant received an invoice for $7,800. Dated March 29, 2020, with payment terms 45215 net 30, and there is a 1% late penalty per month. We want to determine the amount required to pay off the invoice on each of these dates. Although not required, we can represent the payment terms in a timeline. The 4% discount applies if payment is made within 5 days. The 2% will apply after 5 days, but no later than 15 days. And there is no discount after 15 days. The invoice date is March 29th. For the 4% discount that applies within the first 5 days, note that we start counting from the day after the invoice date, and since March has 31 days, the 5 days will be March 30th, March 31st, April 1st, 2nd, and 3rd. Thus, the last day to take the 4% discount is April 3rd. For the 2% discount, we have 15 days from March 29th. We can easily manually determine this date, and we can also use the BA2 Plus calculator. On the BA2 Plus calculator, press 2nd and number 1 for date. For March 29, 2020, input 3.2920 and enter, and then scroll up twice for days between dates and input 15, enter, Then scroll up for date 2 and compute. So the last date to take the 2% discount is April 13th. For 30 days after the invoice date, we can again scroll down to DBD and input 30. Enter and scroll up to date 2 and compute. So the last date to pay without penalty, which is also called credit period, is April 28. Now, April 10 is between April 3rd and 13th. Therefore, a 2% discount applies. And the amount due will be $7,800 minus 2%, which will be $7,644. A payment made on April 3rd falls on the last date to take the 4% discount. So the amount due will be $7,800 minus 4%. Which gives $7,488. For April 20th, which falls between 13th and 28th, no discount applies, so the net invoice amount of $7,800 is due. Lastly, since May 10th is beyond the credit period of April 28th, the 1% penalty will apply, and the amount due will be $7,800 plus 1%. And that gives $7,878. And that's it for this video. Thanks for watching.